Anonymous says, for someone on a keto diet, 80 grams total carbs, 40 g net, greater than one ketones. I assume that's more than one millimolar beta hydroxybutyrate. What supplements would you recommend? Any concerns with carbs being that low? I don't know that I would specifically tailor supplements on the basis of this data. So someone's on a keto diet, they have 80 grams total carbs. I mean, where are the carbs coming from? That's really going to determine whether the person needs supplements. So on a keto diet in general, I think like, and protein too, right? If you're eating a lot of fat instead of protein, then you're going to need supplements of the things that are found in protein foods. If your carbs are all coming from, I don't know, honey, then you're going to need things that are found in vegetables. It's like you just can't tailor it based on that data. But probably the biggest things would be, make sure you're getting a gram of protein per pound of body weight. If your ketones and goals can handle that load of protein, that'll protect you from a lot of nutrient deficiencies right there. Try to cook your proteins in ways that recapture the juices that will help conserve the electrolytes. And you probably want salt and either a lot of low volume, low net carb vegetables, or you're probably going to need more potassium in your diet. So those are the big things that I look at. Anonymous says, are there any brands for getting 1,000 milligrams of resveratrol a day that you've tested and can recommend? I don't know that I recommend taking... Well, actually, I shouldn't say I don't know. I don't currently recommend anyone take resveratrol. And so I, for that reason, don't have a brand to recommend. I guess the reason that I don't recommend resveratrol is... Okay, what is resveratrol doing? Well, almost all of the polyphenols that are found across the plant kingdom are regarded as toxins by the body and upregulate the body's defenses. This is called hormesis, the principle. The principle of hormesis is a little bit of something that's bad is good for you. And you could take... Now, on the other hand, all of these also have very... much more specific effects. So like resveratrol does things that epicatechin and gallate doesn't do and vice versa. Like out of the thousands of polyphenols, they also are effectively natural drugs of sorts because they act on receptors in the body and do specific things. So resveratrol acts through hormesis, but I don't, unless someone has a very targeted reason to do so, I think it's much better to just eat a diet rich in unrefined plant foods as the first thing. If you have signs that your antioxidant defenses are poor and just putting in the nutrients you need doesn't do it, then at that point I might say, well, maybe you want something that acts hormetically. I feel most comfortable with milk thistle in most cases, although I still don't have any brand recommendations on that. For resveratrol, resveratrol also has some effects that are kind of like metformin. And if someone wants me to talk about that, ask it in another question. But I might as well address it here. So there are a lot of things out there that will mimic. I'll say it briefly.